Yo, 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 what's good everybody? This is CPA Strength, strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. What do you do, CPA Strength? I teach the world accounting building blocks by building blocks by building blocks. If this is, happens to be your first time and you're like, yeah, I don't know, I get something about this guy. I think he knows what he's doing or he can't even talk right. But anyways, I'm gonna die of heat stroke is basically what's going on. I got no AC in my building. This is like the fourth time I've tried to do this video. This is the last time I'm gonna do this video. I'm gonna put it out if I don't die trying to do this video. It is what it is. But here's the best playlist in the world. No editing on this one. I don't even care anymore. It just is what it is. I'm gonna put this video out against all odds today. This is the best playlist in the world. Pest accounting playlist. This happens to be Accounting for Beginners number 64, right after 63, yes. This is double declining balance without residual value. We did straight line depreciation, where that is a straight amount of depreciation every year. With these facts, without residual value and stuff, would have been $1,000 depreciation every single year. Now we're doing double declining balance, which is an accelerated depreciation method. Straight line, this would have been 20% a year, 1 divided by 5, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 20% every year. So for double declining balance, we're doubling the percentage. Now remember, it would have been $1,000 a year for straight line depreciation, but now we're taking an accelerated depreciation, so we're taking more depreciation than we would. So we take $2,000 in the first year, $1,200 in the second year, versus if that was straight line, would have been $1,000. On our last example, 63, we had residual value of $500. That means we didn't depreciate the truck lower than the book value of $500. Or the residual value of $500. So we spread it out. We kept on multiplying the book. We both multiplied the book value by the depreciation percentage, and that's how we were getting our depreciation. Now the orange here, is what I changed from what happened in our example when we had a residual value. Because 18 times 40% was 720. So we had 720 depreciation third year, 432 depreciation the fourth year, and then the last year we had $148 of depreciation, so we could end with $500. Book residual value, because that's what we wanted for the residual value. So this time we say, no man, we're just gonna toss the thing away, no residual value. And we're gonna do the double decline balance. We're gonna accelerate the depreciation. We wanna take all our expenses fast. Laugh now, cry later. Here's what happens. Now here's the first change. When you're doing double declining balance, you can decide to take the higher of straight line depreciation or the accelerated depreciation amount, and this will probably come in clear here. So if 1800 times 40%, 720. So that was year three depreciation. And you're like, well, how's that accelerated? Because I could just take straight line and take 1,000. So that's what I want to do. I just want to take the straight line and take 1,000. I don't want this 720. That's what we're doing now. We're going to take this 1,000. We're going to depreciate 1,000 because the double declining balance would be 720, but we have the option to take the higher of the double declining balance or the straight line balance. I hope that makes sense, because if it's so much, whatever. So we take $1,000 depreciation in year four, or year three, sorry, leaving us with 800 book value. So then come to year four here, $4,200 accumulated depreciation, $800 book value at the end of the year. Now 40% of that would be, $300-$400 or whatever. And see, it would go on forever, because you just take a percentage of whatever the value is, and then you multiply it by a percentage, you're never gonna get rid of this number. So just keep that in mind. If you have a residual value, you'll eventually get down to that number. If you don't have a residual value, you'll never really get to zero if you're just multiplying by a percentage. Anywho, we only have $800 left, and we only have $800 left to depreciate our truck. And $800 is less than the $1,000 straight line, so we're just gonna take the whole $800 right here, leaving our truck fully depreciated after 4 years. And the fifth year, we don't even depreciate it. I want to touch on this fact here. See, in the other example we had, we took 720 depreciation 1 year, we took 432 depreciation 1 year, we took $148 depreciation 1 year. All those are less than the straight line, so why did you do that? Well, I was just doing the percentage, and I just wanted to end up with 500 just to show you guys, as the viewers, what would happen. Let's change this up now. Let's change it up on the fly. Audible. Changing this up. We're going back to $500 residual value, right? That's going to be in the blue. We're going back to $500 residual value. But we're not going to use the percentages anymore after it drops under $1,000 of depreciation, because we have that option and we want to use the option of just using it up as fast as we can. We have the option of either the straight line or the accelerated depreciation amount, whatever's the highest of those two, we have the option to take. So we have 500 residual value, but we're going to start using that option in year three. Alright, so we're going to do the same thing in year three. We're just going to take the $1,000 depreciation would be higher if we're taking the straight line, actually, leaving us with $800 book value at the end of the year. So now we need this to end up being 500 at the end. We would just simply, if $800 is the book value at the beginning of the year, we would just simply depreciate 300 here, so we could end up with 500. Just gotta think logically with depreciation, or basically that's with all accounting. You just gotta think, think logically. You gotta think, like, if you're doing your books, or you're making a journal entry depreciation, in real life, for tests, you gotta do what you gotta do. You know, whatever the answer, whatever the teacher's gonna pass you with the grade, that's what you gotta do. You know, in real life, because I am getting a lot of viewers that view my stuff, in real life, or for their jobs, or try to get jobs. What I'm saying is, some of the best advice I got was, just do what you think is right, and you're gonna be fine. And I take it to heart, meaning if I'm doing a tax return, or I'm doing QuickBooks for somebody, or whatever I'm doing in my professional life, there's always twists and turns. Well, what, should I do this or should I do that? And I just do what I think is right. So if anybody questions me on me, questions me about what I've done, I say, well, I think this was the right move. I felt like this was the right thing to do. Like if someone says, oh, you know, you're doing the double declining balance here, and you're supposed to take 40% of 1800, which is 720, but you just took $1,000 depreciation. What'd you do that for? You know, I said, well, I had the option of this and that, and I thought that would be the right thing to do. Anyways, I'm so glad I pushed through. While I was doing this video, I feel the AC come back on, so I'm kind of happy now. So I'm happy I just didn't leave in a huffy puffy. But anyways, hope to see you in the next one. I'm not really sure what we're going to do in the next video. I think we're going to do some examples, but maybe some depreciation examples. I don't know. Let's stay positive. We got to stay positive, because this negativity will get you nowhere. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.